Welcome, gang. Have you all been living marvelously? Today we are whisking you into the terrifying world of the Cthulhu Mythos of H.P. Lovecraft, and our lady monster in focus is Cthylla. Monster sea creatures have been a staple of folklore, mythos, and fanfiction for as long as humans like you and I have loved a good horror story. But when it is done the Lovecraftian way, it is always special, grotesque, and extra weird. What's not to love, right? Cthylla, the secret daughter of Cthulhu, checks all of the above boxes and even distinguishes herself from other sea demons with a disturbing prophecy. She also possesses some amazing powers that have basically rendered her invincible against any and all attacks we Earthlings may conceive for her. So, without any more jibber-jabber, let us get into this gigantic sea princess. Who is Cthylla? What's her story? And what is it that makes her so impervious and dangerous? Real quick, before we get into it, do us a solid. If you like our content, please support us by subscribing. It's a small click for you, but it means a lot to us. Thank you. Cthylla Origins. In the Cthulhu Mythos, a riveting yet revolting world created by horror stalwart H.P. Lovecraft, there exists a giant octopus lady of unsurpassable value to the Cthulhu clan, Cthylla, the secret daughter of Cthulhu. Cthylla is a scion of the alien race called the Great Old Ones, which hails from Zoth, a star in the 23rd nebula. She is the child of Cthulhu and his mate, Idya. Cthylla cuts an enormous bloated figure. She is a massive octopus with monstrous clawed tentacles. Her body is a shade of red, black ringed all over, and her face is furnished with six eyes. Cthylla can move about or change any of her body proportions whenever she feels the need to do it, just like her father Cthulhu. Also, akin to her father, she is equipped with psychic powers, though not quite at the same level as him. Among her siblings, Cthylla was considered the most intelligent. Now, the name Cthylla sounds quite a lot like Cilla, doesn't it? Many believe there is a link between these two names. Cilla is a female sea monster from Greek mythology and could have been the inspiration for the secret daughter's name, tweaking it up some to sound like Cthulhu's progeny. To fully gauge the magnitude of Cthylla's importance to the Cthulhu mythos, one must know about Cthulhu. While most of you watching this video probably already know him, let us summarize him for those who don't. The Great Sleeper, Cthulhu, who has the entire mythos named after him, is a terrible godlike entity introduced by H.P. Lovecraft in the short story called The Call of Cthulhu. He was one of the aliens known as the Great Old Ones. Cthulhu was a green octopus-human hybrid with dragon wings, who stood hundreds of meters tall and had innumerable tentacles that came wriggling out over his head. Now, I know he sounds like a Pirates of the Caribbean monster, but Cthulhu has a distinctive lore to go with him, and the lore was taken to supernatural heights by later authors who expanded the Cthulhu mythos. Within the expert horror plots of writers like August Derleth, Robert E. Howard, Neil Gaiman, and Robert Bloch, Cthulhu became the Great Old One that sleeps in the underwater city of Relia in the depths of the Pacific Ocean, waiting for the day he will fully awaken. Aside from his formidable looks, claws, and tentacles, Cthulhu's psychic energies were also beyond measure, so vast that he could mentally ensnare humans who lived even in the faraway reaches of Earth. But the Emerald City of Relia sank under the seabed for causes that are somewhat vague and remain a topic of speculation. And so, Cthulhu and his children came to be trapped beneath the ancient city, with Cthulhu falling into a deep sleep. So, now that we have established that Cthulhu was a creature of great might who could easily warp human minds to his will from the depths of the ocean, let us go on to his kids. The High Priest of the Great Old Ones, which is one of the many titles Cthulhu goes by, had four children, three sons and Cthylla, who came to be called the Secret Daughter, and we'll get to the reason for this in just a moment. Cthylla's prominence in the mythos came from the significant task she was entrusted with upon birth, regenerating her father if he were to perish. So, in the distant future, when Cthulhu dies, Cthylla will birth him again. This was a big deal for the monster god, making Cthylla his absolute favorite kid and asset. Okay, so you are probably still wondering why Cthylla is called the Secret Daughter. What is so secret about her? And the answer is, well, she is a closely guarded secret by just as many above sea level as under it. While Cthulhu hibernated at the bottom of the ocean bed for ages on end, the human race made several technological advancements on land. But even in his state of slumber, Cthulhu was half-conscious. He made extrasensory contact with many people on land, and a cult of Cthulhu was formed on Earth. Cthylla is called the Secret One by the Cult of Cthulhu, who try to keep her identity and purpose a secret. After all, Cthylla, being the Great Cthulhu's most significant life insurance policy privacy requires the utmost safety, and for a monster of her stature, there is no better way to ensure that than to keep her existence totally hidden. She is also constantly under heavy guard by Lovecraftian ocean dwellers like Yuggs, Yugya, and the Deep Ones. The backstory of the Secret Daughter. Who is Cthylla? It's story time, people. Let's kick off our Cthulhu Mythos tales with the one that first mentioned Cthylla. Cthylla isn't one of the oldest monsters in the Cthulhu Mythos. She first cropped up in the Transition of Titus Crow, an adventure horror novel by Brian Lumley and the second of his Titus series. But Lumley never laid out a crisp description of the secret seed, as he calls her. There wasn't much about her appearance or her personality in his works. After this, Cthylla came into the picture with an attempted assassination of sorts. Project X was a mission undertaken by a team of agents and seamen to kill three Great Old Ones, one of them being Cthylla. But this Project X right here included far larger drills than the namesake one used to inlay Wolverine's skeleton with adamantium in Marvel Comics. So, at the midnight hour of 25th March 1980, one massive drill strapped up to a nuclear weapon was plunged into the ocean, burrowing 4.5 miles deep under Innsmouth's Devil Reef. I'm sure you remember Innsmouth as a fictional locale used many times in Lovecraftian works. The drill aimed to get into the buried city of Relia and destroy the three targets. And as the nuke blew up, the Great Old Ones fled. As for Cthylla, she was injured in this attack, but she did not die. The Wilmarth Foundation, based in the fictitious town of Arkham, the very organization that had wrought the mission of destroying the Great Old Ones, had grossly underestimated Cthulhu's resilience. The mission failed, but it sure succeeded in netting Big Daddy's wrath. Cthulhu's revenge that followed the attempt on his daughter's life was all kinds of mayhem on Earth. Even through the abyss of his slumber, Cthulhu emanated a psychic pulse across the globe, which drove mentally unstable people of the Earth into a violent frenzy and turned many into worshippers of the Great Old Ones. And oh, he also caused a hurricane while he was at it. The last noteworthy story that actually captures Cthylla in incredible detail is In Her Daughter's Darkling Womb by Tina L. Jens. So, Cthylla is captured by a group of scientists who wish to study her. They think Cthylla is an interesting species of octopus they haven't seen before. They are way too excited to observe her unique intelligence and capabilities, growing and dissolving tentacles, enlarging her wings at will, the six eyes and all. Ironically, all the eyes are placed over the front of her head. What a waste, isn't it? Two of them on the back of her head could have been handy. Anyway, this is Lovecraftian horror, which is more about unearthing our deep-seated fears of the unknown and letting our imagination take over instead of resorting to logic at every step. And Cthylla will certainly make your hair stand in this story, which has a psychological drama feel. We watch her from the perspective of a cranky scientist, Catherine Cullum, who has suffered the grim experience of one too many miscarriages to act like Little Miss Sunshine around the creature. Through Dr. Cullum's eyes, we gather much of what we know about Cthylla. Throughout the story's first section, Cullum makes her notes watching the monster in her ginormous tank. Cullum unknowingly ends up doing her part in impregnating Cthylla. How on earth could she achieve that, you might wonder? Well, it is a whole tentacle camo robot sweat and in vitro fertilization thing. That is the weird part of this story, but apparently, the experiment worked. The story tries to play within the larger narrative of Cthulhu returning to life through his daughter, Cthylla's womb. And while the story itself isn't the most stimulating read, it is a worthy carry forward for Cthylla's lore. In The Hall of the Yellow King by Peter Rawlick, where many Lovecraftian alien races have a catch-up, Cthylla is a potential bride for Hastur, another mysterious entity of the Cthulhu mythos. But in this story, Cthylla has a more human-like appearance. Cthylla's powers. Aside from the ability to manipulate her body proportions, which we've already covered, and the super strength that a creature of her magnitude is obviously capable of, Cthylla also has some other powers in her package. Regeneration. Cthylla's survived and recovered from a nuclear explosion that was specially directed at her. This clearly shows that she has inherited her father's immense regenerative powers, and there would be few ways, if any, with which a mere human could hope to destroy her. Psychic abilities. Cthylla shows signs of potent psychic prowess over Catherine Cullum in the story In Her Daughter's Darkling Womb. She is able to take over Cullum's thoughts and lead the doctor into believing she will birth a half-octopus, half-human baby after Dr. Cullum becomes pregnant. And there are other moments in the book where you feel her mentally messing with the crew. In contrast to her father, Cthylla's psychic range isn't half as strong, but she has inherited his gift and may develop devastating powers akin to his over time. Flight. Though Cthulhu has wings, there isn't an instance of her taking flight, but it is said that she can enlarge her wings until they are big enough for her to fly. So she definitely can fly, but we will have to wait until her lore is extended to watch the secret daughter in her full glory. Well, at least her popularity has given her a good presence in some popular media franchises. Cthulhu in pop culture. Cthulhu has definitely followed in her father Cthulhu's footsteps when it comes to getting herself enlisted in popular video and online games. She is a character in Chaos Code, a 2D fighting game developed by FK Digital. Cthulhu finds a spot inside PlayStation and Nintendo gaming sets through this game. In the Lovecraftian open-world game The Sinking City, Cthulhu acts as the chief catalyst that drives the whole thing. Along with her occult factions, she tries to coerce Charles Reed, the protagonist, a World War I vet and private investigator, into releasing her from a sunken temple. Her goal, as always, is to get free and rebirth the great sleeper of Relia, Cthulhu. In the Japanese manga Digimon franchise, Cthulhu has a mysterious Phantom of the Sea character after her. It is called Cthulhamon. This video game has a cute Psy-looking monster theme, and within the players, Cthulhamon is a dangerous sea fairy of sorts, while still in an adorable cartoon rendition of Digimon than how she is seen in the more serious artworks dedicated to her. Cthulhu retains her psychic terror edge by floating around the sea in spooky fashion and controlling other water Digimon to fight in her stead. Cthulhu also appeared as a girl donning a purple octopus head over her hair in the popular mobile phone game Devil Maker, Tokyo. Though this game is no longer in circulation, it was hugely popular when it was around. Marvelous verdict. Lovecraftian work is always about tugging on the fears that already reside within us. Very few authors have been able to understand and scribe such widespread stories and series that bring out the fear of the unknown, quite like Lovecraft has. Cthulhu and her great old ones fall squarely within this box. We do not always care to imagine what lies in the dark depths of a sea, which even sunlight cannot fathom. The images of large, mysterious beings with abundant powers beyond our imagination come to mind. And with Cthulhu, it's like this exact fear is taken and molded into a portrait. Cthulhu's story does not show her as an evil-minded creature, but as one who is simply trying to realize her destiny, which is to keep herself safe until she is required to reincarnate her father, Cthulhu. Her evil actions are purely a means to this end. This is also the biggest reason I feel she'll make a great villain in future Lovecraftian tales or animations, because she isn't a clever and greedy kind who is always battling against her conscience as she does horrible things. It is always the ones like Cthulhu, those who don't think about their actions and are just programmed to do whatever they need to get theirs, that turn out to be doubly dangerous bad guys, or in this case, bad girls. Am I right, fam? That'll be all about that. But on a completely different note, do remember, viewers, it is September, a month that is always trying its best to make us forget all about the summer roast. Shout out to Bernard Williams. So go on, make a day of it. If you enjoyed this video, please smash the like button and subscribe if you haven't already.